The brain uses more energy than any other part of the body, and glucose, a type of sugar derived from the food we eat, is its main fuel source. But what happens to the brain when it's exposed to excessive amounts of sugar that many people have in their diet? Well, more is definitely not better. I unpack why excessive sugar impairs mood, memory, and self-control, and how to avoid these dangers by satisfying our sweet tooth. Let's discuss. Welcome to episode 110 of Better Brain, Better You. Hello, I'm neuroscientist Dr. Ben Webb, sharing brain advice for a mentally healthy and happy life. How are you doing? Hope you're having a great week. Thanks for joining me for today's episode on the damage that too much sugar does to your brain. So quick reminder that I'm starting a new series of live monthly workshops on brain care this Thursday. In this month's brain care workshop, I'm going to break down how to use food to boost brain health and sharpen memory. I'll break down the importance of nutrition for a healthy brain, the foods to eat and avoid to maximize your intake of brain healthy nutrients to keep the brain young and improve memory. So I'll be going live at 7 p.m. on Thursday, 22nd of September. There'll also be a live Q&A with me at the end where you can ask me your questions about using nutrition for your brain health and memory. So to attend this free live event, you can register at ologyonlinecourses.com/food memory. That's ologyonlinecourses.com/food memory. So if you can't make it, make sure you register anyway to receive the replay link. So I look forward to seeing you there. Okay, so let's jump into today's content. The brain uses more energy than any other organ in the body, and glucose, that's a type of sugar we get from the foods we eat, is its main source of fuel. But what happens when the brain is exposed to an excessive amount of sugars in the standard Western diet? In the brain, excess sugar impairs both our cognitive skills and our self-control. So for many people, having some sugar stimulates a craving for more. Sugar acts like a drug in the reward center of the brain. Sweet foods, as well as salty and fatty foods, can produce addiction-like effects in the brain, leading to a loss of self-control, overeating, and weight gain. So in our evolutionary history, this sort of stimulus helped us to find and consume calorie-rich foods for our survival when food was scarce. But now, this ancient drive inside our brain contributes to the obesity and diabetes epidemics that we are experiencing right now. So the behaviors and brain mechanisms driving substance abuse and overeating are quite similar. And the notion of food addiction is gaining traction amongst scientists. High glycemic foods, which are broken down quickly by your body and cause a spike in blood glucose, activate the parts of the brain associated with reward, provoking more intense feelings of hunger compared to low glycemic foods. So those that release glucose more slowly and steadily. So foods that cause a spike in blood glucose are more addictive for the brain. So overeating also alters our brain's reward system, which then further drives the desire to eat more. So this same process is thought to underlie the tolerance associated with addiction. So is sugar truly addictive? Well, the short answer seems to be yes. Over time, greater amounts of sugar are required to reach the same level of reward. And studies suggest that overeating results in a smaller reward response and a progressively worsening addiction to low nutrient foods rich in sugar, salt, and fat. So sweet foods can actually be more addictive than cocaine, according to some research. So for animals, intense sweetness can surpass the pleasure derived from cocaine. Throughout the body, too much sugar is harmful. Even a single instance of elevated glucose in the bloodstream can be harmful to the brain, resulting in slower thinking and impaired memory and attention. So high sugar consumption causes inflammation in the brain, leading to memory difficulties. And inflammation has also been found in the hippocampus, that's the part of the brain involved in learning and memory, of animals fed on a high sugar diet. So the good news is that this inflammatory damage from sugar may not be permanent. The memory damage caused by sugar consumption can be reversed by following a low sugar, low glycemic index diet. So sugar also changes our mood. In healthy young people, the ability to process emotions is compromised when blood glucose levels are elevated. And people with type 2 diabetes can also experience increased feelings of sadness and anxiety during periods of elevated blood sugar. And one of the largest studies to link sugar with depression, that's an investigation of the diet and mood of more than 20,000 people, found higher rates of sugar consumption was associated with a greater incidence of depression. So people with the highest level of sugar consumption were 23% more likely to be diagnosed with a mental disorder than those with the lowest sugar intake. And elevated blood glucose also harms blood vessels. So blood vessel damage is the major cause of the vascular complications of diabetes, stroke, and dementia. So long-term diabetics experience progressive brain damage, leading to deficits in learning, memory, motor speed, and other cognitive functions. And frequent exposure to high sugar levels reduces mental capacity and has been associated with a greater degree of brain shrinkage. So even in those without diabetes, higher sugar consumption is associated with poorer cognitive function. So these effects are caused by a combination of hyperglycemia, hypertension, insulin resistance, and elevated cholesterol. So a diet high in added sugar also reduces the production of brain-derived neurotrophic factor. That's called BDNF. That's a brain chemical essential for generating new brain cells, new memory formation, and learning. And lower levels of BDNF are also linked to dementia and Alzheimer's disease. So as the research shows, any sugar added in our food is dangerous, but we can avoid these dangers by satisfying our sweet tooth with fresh fruit in place of refined sugars. Eating fresh fruit provides the satisfying sweetness of sugary treats with the extra bonus of fruits, fiber, antioxidants, and phytochemicals that slow down the surge of sugar in the bloodstream and block its negative effects on our brain health, mood, and memory. So as I mentioned at the top of the show, I'm going live at 7 p.m. on the Thursday the 22nd of September in the first installment of my monthly brain care workshops. I'm going to unpack how to use food to boost your brain health and memory. You can register to attend this free workshop at ologyonlinecourses.com/food memory. That's ologyonlinecourses.com/food memory. So thanks so much for joining me for today's episode on what sugar really does to our brain. I hope you found it helpful. Here's to your brain health and well-being, and I will look forward to seeing you next time.